Hey there everyone, welcome to another video of Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020, the latest of all. And for today's video, I'd like to perform an ILS approach on how to conduct one, if I should say. So here we are on the Cessna 152, Alpha Sierra X-Ray Golf Sierra, that's the call sign. And I pretty much established and made an arrival at Craig Municipal, that's Charlie Romeo Golf in Jacksonville, Florida. It's a Class D airspace, airport, I should say. So I already have everything tuned in, the frequency for the localizer is 101.7. I'm just here just trying to turn the radio around 321 degrees, because that's our, hypothetically, our heading that we should be at on when we're doing the ILS approach. So we're just assuming that ATC has assigned us an altitude of 1,900, and then so forth. Momentarily, they're probably going to assign us to a heading around 90 degrees so we can become established with the localizer. You're going to notice that the VFR map is displayed in bottom light, bottom left of the screen. I'm not really actually looking at it. It's just for reference for everyone to look at. I'm actually focused on the cockpit itself, the instruments. I'm not even looking at the screen. So right now, what I'm doing is I'm trying to identify and make sure that I have the correct frequency, because there are sometimes pilots make mistakes. We all make mistakes. We're not perfect, so this is one important way of identifying whether we're on the correct frequency. So I am quite confident that I already got the correct one. So I was just showing you how to really do it. In reality, just pull that knob, and then you'll hear a certain Morse code that tells you what frequency you're actually tuning in on. So I already did that slide, so that's part of my checklist to make sure that I am doing everything all correctly. Now I'm going to be turning, let's assume ATC told us to make a left turn somewhere around 30 degrees, nothing more than that. So that we come established with the localizer. Adears is our final approach fix. So that means we can't go lower than 1,900 as displayed on the approach plate until we become established across the final approach fix. Or, unless the glide slope becomes alive and active, then we can start descent from there. And right now you're going to notice that the needle that gives you lateral guidance is already turning alive. It's already active, so this is a good time to turn to heading of 321 as assigned on the approach plate. Now I overshot it, but that's no problem. You can correct it back in by just adding slight 10 degrees like to the left, like 312 until you can 311 just to correct it. And now the glide slope, the one that gives you the up and down guidance, is already active, so that means that we are on the final approach fix and that we may continue to descend from there. So right now I'm just going to pull the power slightly, give it a stabilized approach. We're going to pull in carb heat so we can descend a little bit faster from that. So just, you know, and I'll add one notch of flaps. So right now we're in good position. Right now we're very stabilized. I'm not really erratic or anything. I'm actually straight. All I have to do is maintain the glide slope. Make sure the line's not below. I'm not above the line or below it. Right there, I think the best approach is to stabilize approach like around 500. Nothing more than 1,000, because that would be considered unstable. That would mean that you have to conduct a missed approach from there. So right now I'm just continuing for right there, nothing, not doing much anything, just making sure that the lines are exact cross. It doesn't have to be exact, but as long it has to be as close as possible to make sure you're actually on a stable approach. You see, an ILS is pretty much the best option for you if you're doing IFR operation or anything, because it gives you the lowest minimum among all approaches. And this is this approach is the only precise one that's well known among aviation training. in actual reality, when you're actually doing the approach, you always want to make sure you brief it out by from top to bottom, left to right. So our minimum, the lowest altitude we can be at is 241. That's what we call a decision height or decision altitude, which means that at that height, we should either have the runway in sight or we have to discontinue, abandon the landing, and go amiss from there. But it's quite obvious right now I have the runway in sight, so it's no issue. But in terms of fogginess, if the weather is so horribly deteriorated that it's like zero visibility, and you're at 241 feet, and you don't have the runway in sight, you can't make the landing. You just got to go full throttle and miss the approach from there. But in our case, we have the runway in sight, so we may continue the approach with no hesitation. So like I said, all you have to do is make sure that the lines are vertical, lateral lines are at a cross. So that means if, for example, the vertical line is below us, we just got to follow that line to reestablish it. So think about it like this. If the line's above us, we just got to stop descending. Just keep it straight and level until the line comes back down, just like that. And apply power so you don't lose any airspeed. Just like that. Now, if the line's below us, just pitch for it. You know, just decrease your speed. You know, pitch downwards. You know, chase the line, but not chase it, literally. Now, since we're at our minimum altitude 241, we have the runway in sight, so we may continue it. So we're actually going visual for now. Disregard that message. So right now we're just going visual. We're gonna make that landing on 3-2, and we are good to go. I'm just gonna try to butter this landing. And then a little bit. Already at a third notch. So pull the power idle. Let the plane slow down. Let the airspeed die off, and we are good. Right there. Couldn't even tell you landed, huh? And there you have it. That's how you conduct an ILS approach. Hopefully you find this informative. But don't take this as an actual lesson. This is just for reference. Just to get familiar with it. Just to get familiar with the idea how to conduct an approach. So hopefully you found this informative, and if you like any further videos, for example VORs, RNAVs, localizer approaches, heck, I can even do the Airbus approaches if you like, because I think that's quite a trend. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll be seeing you guys in the next video.